Welcome to Polecats TV. My name is Chris, and as usual, I will be your host for today. Corinne, Kayleen, and I are going to be taking Natasha out, hopefully, show her a little bit of Pinoy culture as we take her around today.
As she requested.
As she requested. Natasha Wang, this one's for you. But before we stuff ourselves silly, I'm gonna talk to her a little bit, ask a few things before you get too busy eating with us. All right, so Natasha, how long, when did you arrive?
I got here yesterday.
And how were your first set of workshops?
Awesome.
Any memorable things that happened during the workshop? What was your favorite part?
Well, there was just a really good energy. There's so many people in the workshop. Mm-hmm. Specifically memorable things, I mean, I thought it was really cute that the studio printed out these little, certificates. So we had a little photo op session afterwards where I was handing out everyone's certificate.
How long have you been doing pole?
8 years, then really seriously for like 2.5 years.
What were you doing before you started doing pole dancing seriously?
PR. I was a publicist for 9 years. There was some overlap. I mean, I was, you know, competing at the same time as I was working, but when I won USPDF Nationals, that's when I decided I can't do this.
Yeah.
I can do pole and work full time.
Then you chose pole. What made you choose pole?
Fun.
It's one of the things that we like to advocate. It's that everyone can do it.
Yeah.
You know, but it looks fantastic. It looks hard, but if you work hard enough, everyone can be a great pole dancer.
Yeah.
What would you say to them, you to encourage them to just keep on doing it?
Well, I started taking classes when I was 28 or 29, and now I'm 36. You're able to find your own unique skill set.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you're older, but if you're older, you can bring a maturity into your performances that maybe a younger person may not be able to access. If you, maybe you're not super flexible, but maybe you're really strong. And then you can focus on your strength. So there's, you can find your own way to set yourself apart as a performer. So yeah, it's really a sport for everyone.
Just keep on doing it.
Yeah.
Well, we'll have more of her later on. We'll be taking Kayleen actually will be taking the workshop with you later. So right now we're quite ready to have some lunch.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.